Hello all. So previous tutorial we have gone through some PUBG bike tutorials. So we'll be continuing this tutorials after this tutorials. So I'm just going to continue with the new tutorial. So in this tutorial we are going to model, texture and light a 3D exhibition stall in Autodesk 3ds Max using V-Ray. So let's get started. So as you can see over here, we have need to take the reference, go into rendering, view image file, and let's take the reference of this exhibition stall. Let's open this reference. So very first of all, we are going to start with the modeling part. So let's take a plane over here. So take a plane. So you can draw a plane using any of the views. So you can use the top view also if you want to use the plane over here. Now let's click over here, go to the top view, and we can draw a wall over here. So let's draw a wall over here. So we can draw the wall part over here. So you can just go into this AC extended and let's take a wall. So if it is a straight wall, see, you have some kind of a snap options. You can activate this snap options over here. So even you can just press S to activate this snap options. So now you can just keep this stuff over here, you can resize this. Now the next part over here is we need to create this part of it over here. For that, what we can do is we can go into this view over here. Let's take a line tool. Let's take a line tool and let's draw some shape over here, which is going to be covered over here like this. So click over here, rendering, enable in viewport, and click on rectangular and increase its thickness. So after creating a wall, you can just go to the vertex, and if you like to shift it like this a bit over here, you can easily shift this wall over here. Alright. So you can increase its thickness over here. So just click over here and you can increase the width of it. Select the vertex over here and you have an option over here. That's your fillet option. So you can use a bit of fillet option. If you require it, you can utilize the fillet option. And also you can increase the width option. That's it. Now, the next part over here, if you zoom and see, so we can just extend this wall part, or you can just convert to editable poly. Select the vertices and you can just push it a bit back like this. Click over here and can increase its width accordingly. Now the next part over here we are going to do is like convert to editable poly for this also, and just select this and shift this over here. Just select it, go to the top view, and we are just going to duplicate this part again. So for duplicating it, you can just take it as angle as 90 degree, press E, shift and rotate it, press W, copy it and push it over here like this. That's it. So now you can push this part a bit in front. and you can manage to join both of this. So you can manage to join. So you have an option over here, that's your attach. So you can just select and you can just attach it. Or if you don't want to attach it, you can just directly convert it into poly and you can just join this two parts. So you can take this part over here, take this part, that's it. So convert to editable poly, click over here and attach it. So you just attach this part over here. Just shift this a bit over here like this. So if you directly attach this, or if you directly bridge it, you can easily bridge it. If you bridge it, it's going to be in this way. So let's undo this part. So what we are going to do is we'll just extrude this part over here. That's it. Okay. And the rest of the part, click this and this and this and give a bridge option. That's it. So as you can see over here, we have bridge this particular stuff over here like this. Now what you can do is you can use a swift loop over here and use this polygon, and you can just extrude this part up till here. You know, you can just define it. So as you can see over here, the size, the height of this particular stuff is a bit taller. You can just increase the height of this according to the walls. Just select and extrude it and click OK. That's it. So let's save the file. So you can save it as a project folder also. So we'll make a folder over here. That's your D drive, and this we have your exhibition. So install_11. Save it. Okay, so we have just saved this part. Click OK. Now the next part is like you need to model this part. It's a simple part over here. So let's go into this front view over here. Let's take a line, or you can also use a rectangle over here. So let's click on the rectangle tool and make a rectangle over here. After making a rectangle, we can just use a extrude option. Click on the extrude option. Just scale it over here. Keep it at the center. So if you like to keep it at the center, you can just keep it at the center. After you are done, you can convert to editable spline. So before that also you can do that. So of this stuff, first you can convert this to editable spline, go into vertex and use the fillet option. So after you are using a fillet option, just click OK, extrude and click OK. That's it. So as you can see over here, we have just made the stuff over here. So again, shift and rotate it, click OK. And now as you can see over here, it's inversed. So you can just push this over here, and you have an option over here that's for the mirror. So you can mirror it in whatever axis you want. and just click OK. So as you get this stuff like this over here, let's go to the top view. Click over here like this. Push this. Even can increase decrease this stuff. So convert to spline vertex and fillet it according to this. That's it. And let's use the extrude modifier over here and push it over here like this on the top view. That's it. So now you can just go into this vertex, activate this and push this over here. That's it. Extrusion part which we have done over here should be the same as compared to here. So just click over here and you can just push the stuff over here. Go into vertex and push this like this. That's it. Okay. So you can increase decrease it according to your choice. You can just mirror the stuff over here. That's it. Alright. So if you want to keep it as one, you can easily keep it as one. So you can just take it over here, select this both, convert to editable poly, select this, shape over here, push it over here. So now we can just take a swift loop like this, select this, attach it with this. So now you have the two shapes over here. That's it. What you can do is you can try to, you know, get this stuff in the straight line. Select the same at the bottom. Try to get this back in the straight line. So select this stuff, this one. Okay, I think you don't get the loop over here, so we need a actual loop over here. So let's select it, Alt and Q. So we didn't get the loop just because of this part. So you can just take a cut option over here. Let's take a cut over here and take a edge down. That's it. So you can just resize this stuff over here and select this and this and give a ridge option. That's it. So and isolate this part. So as you can see, we have just modeled this part over here. So for the lights part, we are just going to use the cylinder over here. So we'll go to the top view and use some kind of cylinders. We use the auto grid option and cylinders from where your light is going to emit. So we don't need so many segments for the such part. You can just push this up. That's it. Okay. So you can just select it and you can just make the copies of it. So press shift and make the copies. That's it. So you can take one more copy over here. Okay. Shift this over here. duplicate this stuff over here. Make the copies. That's it. So delete this part. So just select all of this and give a color. So let's save this file. Okay. So we'll continue the rest of the part in the next tutorial. So thanks for watching this tutorial.